he had plaques on his brain, and it was younger onset Alzheimer's disease, and he had just turned 50. When we found out it was Alzheimer's, it devastates. It changes every single thing in your world, and it's an instant loss of dreams. They all just go away, and so you lose vision. You lose vision for what your future will look like because it's nothing that you'd planned for. Jose and I met, we were both in the Army. I had just come back from Operation Desert Storm, and he was a social worker, I was a nurse. There was a sick baby, and we had to call the social worker to make plans for the baby to be sent to Oklahoma City, because we were in Lawton, Oklahoma at Fort Sill. We've been married almost 23 years in September. I wasn't looking for Alzheimer's disease that has no cure. I wasn't looking for that. So it is shocking. It takes your breath away, and it's destabilizing up front when you're initially diagnosed.
Well, we've been married for 41 and a half years. So we got married in 1975. We met in 1970. So known him for a long time. He was a United Methodist minister. We were fortunate to have a doctor who diagnosed him who was very clear and careful about some things. He said to my husband, since you're a retired minister, I want you to start preaching the gospel of Alzheimer's. He said it's important not to keep it a secret. Tell your friends, tell people that you have it. He was always so appreciative and thankful that I was able to be here with him. I mean, we had an awful lot of good days. They were different than the good days were 10 years ago, but we were still together and enjoying each other.
We've never tried to hide this or anything, and actually we're hoping that by being more public with his diagnosis, people will get a better idea of what Alzheimer's disease is and how it affects the person, and along with that, how it affects the caregivers and the family. What's needed in research, what's the funding that's needed to increase. How it's changed me, though, is being more protective of him, almost to an annoyance. It's almost like you protect your child. You get mama bear claws out sometimes. Protective of who he talks with and when he's talking to people and what plans he's making. And it's also changed me in that I don't think I'm as social and as outgoing and as friendly probably as I used to be, because I'm busy watching what he's doing, managing a lot of the things that we used to co-manage, like the household things. And I'm tired, to be perfectly honest. There was at one point where I was really just angry that not at Dennis, of course, and or anybody, but just at the disease, like, darn it, why?
I always say there's no emotion known to man that is not felt in the experience of Alzheimer's disease. There's always a surprise. There's always a surprise as to when. It impacts lifestyle really on every level. So the emotions, you know, range from grief and anger and sadness and adjustment, and actually there's potential to grow. There's a potential to become closer as a family. I never in all these years look at a family or a person that's been diagnosed as hopeless. It doesn't have to be a sentence of suffering, that there is quality of life to be lived. And the important things don't go away.